Hi, welcome to DBV Technology. In this video, we will learn how to pair two Bluetooth modules as master and slave devices. So let's get started.
You can buy all types of electronic components, modules, sensors at best price from www.dbvtechnology.com.
To pair these Bluetooth modules, we have to first configure both the modules. One as a master device and another as a slave device. This can be done by sending AT commands, that is attention command, to these modules. So let us first do that. So let us first configure any one of our Bluetooth devices as slave device. So here is our connection diagram. So here we can see the RX pin of the Bluetooth module is connected to RX pin of the Arduino through a voltage divider. Then TX pin of the Bluetooth module is connected to TX pin of the Arduino. In general case, we use RX pin to TX pin of the Arduino and TX pin to RX pin of the Arduino. But in this case, we have to use RX to RX and TX to TX. Then we have to connect this GND pin of the Arduino to the module to GND pin of the Arduino and VCC pin of the Bluetooth module to 5V pin of the Arduino. Also, in this case, we have to connect this EN pin of the Bluetooth module to 5V pin of the Arduino. Here is our connection diagram. We are not using the voltage divider resistor here from RX to RX. Because I am using this for short time. If you are using for short time, then without that resistors, it will also work.
Now open your Arduino IDE and upload this blank code. But before uploading, you have to remove these TX and RX wires from the Arduino and then upload it. So here, done uploading. Now we have to connect these two wires again.
Now press and hold this small button here, press and hold, and then you power the Arduino through USB. Now we can see this LED. Let me switch off the light. We can see the LED, the status LED on the Bluetooth module is flashing every after 2 seconds. That means we have successfully entered in the AT command mode.
Now from your Arduino IDE, go to serial monitor and then write capital A, capital T, then press enter. So again, capital A, capital T, press enter. So it returns OK. That means it is now in AT command mode. Now write capital A, capital T, that is AT plus UART, then question mark, then press enter. So here we can see the default baud rate of this Bluetooth module is 38400. So this baud rate should be same for the master device also. Then it will be able to communicate with each other. So another thing is here, we have to keep this here 38400, and this is both NL and CR mode. So now AT plus UART, question mark. So now here, now after that, we have to type AT plus ROLE role, question mark, then press enter. So here role equal role 0. That means role 0 means it is in slave mode. By default, the Bluetooth module always in slave mode. So it is in slave mode. Now we have to write AT plus ADDR, ADDR, then question mark, and then press enter. So here we can see this is the address of this Bluetooth module that we will use as slave. So we have to copy this address and keep it in notepad, because we will use this address during configuration of master module. Now our slab is ready. Now use the same connection diagram to configure the other Bluetooth module as master device. After the connection, we have to upload this blank sketch again to the master module also. So upload this code for the master module also. And then you press and hold a small button on the master Bluetooth module and then enter into the AT mode. Now go to this serial monitor, and here we have to send the command to configure the Bluetooth module as master device. Here also we have to keep it at 38400, and here both NL and CR. Now let us go and type AT and then press enter. So okay, then AT plus UART to check the board rate. So AT plus UART, then question mark. So then press enter. So we can see the board rate is 38400. So in some cases the board rate may be different from 38400. If it is different, then you have to set it at 38400. For that you have to send command AT plus UART then equal. If it is, suppose it was 9600, then we have to set it 38400. So 38400, 0, 0 and then press enter. So now after that, after this command, the board rate will be 38400. So let us check it again. AT UART then question mark. So press enter. So we can see 38400. Now after this, we have to set the role of this module as 1, because the role for the slab was 0. So AT plus ROLE then equal 1, then press enter. So okay, so now we will check it. AT plus ROLE then question mark, then press enter. So we can see role is 1, means it will act as master device. So after this command, we have to set another command, AT plus CMODEC mode equal 0, then press enter. So okay, so this will set the connect mode to fixed address. That means if we will not send AT plus CMODE equal 0, then it will connect to all the available devices. But after sending AT plus CMODE, it will only connect to the addresses that we will provide. So now we will provide the address of the slab module. So AT plus BIND. So AT plus BIND, then equal, then we have to pass the parameter of our slab module. That is the address of the slab module here. So here 9D98D3. After that, in the address there was semicolon, but instead of semicolon we have to write here comma. So replace the semicolon with comma. So here we have replaced this as comma. Then we have to press enter. Now it will connect only to the slab module, not to other Bluetooth module. So our configuration for the master is ready. Here is our circuit connection. So this side shows the master connection and this side shows the slab connection. So here we can see we have to use this, we have to connect this RX terminal to TX and TX to RX in this case. Now here we can see we have used one push button here. When we press this push button, the LED in the slab side will turn on. That means this LED. I am using here a red LED here, and here in the master side one green LED. So when I press this push button in the master side, the LED in the slab side will turn on. And when I press this push button in the slab side, the LED in the master side will turn on. I am using 10mm LED, that's why I am not using resistor in between this positive terminal of the LED and this pin number 8. But if you use 5mm LED, then you have to use a 100 ohm or 220 ohm resistor in between this positive terminal of the this LED and this pin number 8. That means here you have to use one resistor. Also this side you have to use one resistor. The link is given in the description. You can download from there. So let us see the circuits now. So here is our circuit. So this side master side, and this is the master Bluetooth module, and this side slave side. So here is the slave Bluetooth module. So first we have to upload the code one by one. First we will upload the code to the master side. So connect your Arduino to your laptop and upload the code of the master side. The link of the code is given in the description of this video. Please don't forget to remove these TX and RX wires during uploading the code. I have already uploaded it. Now you connect the Arduino to the laptop and upload the code to this slab side. So the code link is given in the description. Now you connect this also. So I have already uploaded it. Now we can see this, the status LEDs now flashing every after 2 seconds. That means these are now automatically connected with each other. Here we can see this is the pause button in the master side, and here is the pause button in the slab side, and here is the green, sorry, here is the red LED in the slab side, and here is the green LED in the master side. So first we will press this pause button in the master side, and we can see the red LED turn on. So we can see when I press and hold it, so it is now on, and when I leave it, so it is off. Similarly, when I press this pause button in the slab side, the LED in the master side turn on. So here is the code for the master side, and here is the code for the slab side. So in the master side, at the beginning of the code, we have connected our green LED pin at pin number 8. Then the master switch pin, that means the push button, at pin number 7. And we have defined one variable, integer type variable, data from slab, to store the data coming from the slab module. Then in the void setup, we kept the pin mode of the green LED pin as output, and at the beginning of the code, the LED will be in off state. Then here is the input. Pin mode is input for master switch pin, that means for the push button, and the value is low. And then serial.begin 38400, this is the default baud rate of the master Bluetooth module. Then in the void loop section, at the beginning of the void loop section, we have written if serial.available is greater than 0, that means if there is data from the slab module, then the data will be read and the data will be stored in the data from slab variable. And we will now test the if data from slab is equal 1, that means if the data sent by the slab module is 1, then we turn on the green LED, digital right, green LED high. Else if data from slab is equal 0, if the data coming from the slab is equal to 0, then we turn off the green LED. Then after that, this code for the push button. So at the beginning here, we can see the value of the push button is read, that is digital read master switch pin, and that value is stored in the master switch value. And if master switch value equal high, that means if we press the push button, press and hold the push button, then the value will be high, and in that case we send the value 1 to the Bluetooth module, that is to the slab module. And if the button is not pressed, then we send value 0 to the slab module. Similarly here for the slab side. You can buy all types of electronic components, modules, sensors at best price from www.dpvtechnology.com.